All right, let's talk markets now. Joining us for that is Jason Wherry, partner and chief investment officer at Albion Financial. And here on set is Chris Moore, managing partner and chief investment officer at Simon Quick Advisors. Good morning to you both. Chris, I'll start with you here. I mean, we're sitting here on track with the S&P 500 going to give you a 30% plus total return this year. 1 year ago, I didn't hear a lot of people say S&P's going up 30% because earnings are going to be flat. Fed's going to cut rates. We're not going to have a pullback more than 6 or 7%. Where do we stand right now? I mean, did we do too much this year to leave it for next year?
Sure. Coming into the year, markets were really wasn't expecting much from markets, right? As you mentioned, everyone was a little kind of concerned about what might happen in 2019. But really, it was a Fed-driven market. You know, we think that the Fed cutting rates three times here in this year really drove markets a whole lot higher. And then secondly, a lot of the news around trade negotiations, especially here in kind of the last, call it 60 days, has helped move markets a whole lot higher. So we're in a position now where there's a lot of momentum at the back of stocks. And, you know, we think certainly the high returns are behind us, but definitely going to close out a really strong year.
Jason, that is pretty much the way the math seems to work in terms of valuations right now. We're going to return to earnings growth next year, though, so we're going to grow from essentially record levels of profits. If you don't see a recession around the corner, the market tends to find a way to kind of get higher one way or another. So how do you think investors ought to be thinking about next year? Which is the direction of surprise, do you think, away from that consensus that says we're going to get low single-digit returns?
Yeah, I think as we look at the setup going into 2020, the good news is that while the Fed's unlikely to deliver any more rate cuts in 2020, I think they're at a neutral posture for now. Meanwhile, we have an economy that's growing, you know, at about 2%, and we have corporate earnings, as you guys mentioned, that, you know, we're down slightly or about flat year over year, but should pick up. And as we look at the market, I mean, typically stock prices follow earnings. So if earnings are going to grow next year somewhere in the order of mid to upper single digits, I mean, I think that's good news for the markets, though one could argue that perhaps some of this year's rally is pricing in that return to growth. But I think the most important thing to think about is over the near term, and your other guests mentioned this, that it's really about reality versus expectations. And the setup going into 2020, the hurdle's a little bit higher. We're not going to get the Fed cutting interest rates, as I mentioned. The expectations for the economy, I think, are fairly balanced. You'll recall last year at this time, recession was on everybody's mind. And I think right now people have a little bit higher expectations for what's happening in the economy and what's happening in corporate profits. So again, a little bit higher hurdle. So I think the direction of the market looks okay. But at the same time, I think if things come in below current expectations, we might get a little bit of volatility.